Hello everyone, welcome to Data Fuse Analytics. In this video, I will explain generative model families in detail. This video aims to provide data scientists with a better understanding of which family of generative models to choose based on the specific problem that they want to solve. Now, this video will offer valuable insights to guide their decision making in generative AI domain. Let's start with the aim of generative models. Although all the generative models try to achieve the same goal, they use varying methods to model this probability density function, or P of X. Now, talking about this probability density function, this is a function that maps a point in sample space to a number between 0 and 1. The integral of probability density function over all the points in sample space must be equal to 1, so that this is a well-defined probability distribution. Now that we have got the idea of probability density function in generative models, let's directly jump to the family of generative models. So let's start by dividing these generative models into two groups. First group is where we explicitly model a probability density function, and the another group is where we implicitly model the probability density function. Now, if we look in the explicit density models, we have two types of models in explicit density models. They are approximate density models. These approximate density models only optimize an optimization of density function. And the next group is tractable density models. Now, these tractable density models, they directly optimize the density function. Now, coming back to approximate density functions, we have autoencoders, energy-based models, and diffusion models. Now, let me talk a brief about all these three. Autoencoder mainly include variational autoencoders. They introduce a latent variable, or we call it as a hidden variable in simpler terms, and optimize an approximation of joint density function. These energy-based models also utilize approximate method, but they use Markov chain sampling rather than variational methods. Now, finally, coming to diffusion models, these diffusion models approximate the density function by training a model to gradually denoise a given image that has been previously corrupted with some noise. Now, let me talk few points about tractable density models. Now, these tractable density models place constraints on the model architecture so that density function has a form that makes it easy to calculate. In tractable density models, we have autoregressive models and normalizing flows. Autoregressive models place ordering on input features so that output can be generated in sequential manner or sequentially. For example, word by word in text generation or pixel by pixel in image generation. Normalizing flows apply a series of tractable invertible functions to a simple distribution in order to generate more complex distributions. Now that we have covered all the explicit density models, let's move to the right hand side and let's move to implicit density models. Now, these implicit density models, they do not aim to estimate any probability density explicit density models, but instead these implicit density models focus solely on producing a stochastic process, or we call it as a random process, which directly generates the data. The best known example in implicit density model is generative adversarial network. Now, I want to share one tip with you guys. We have to keep in mind that all these groups or all this family, they are not mutually exclusive and they are not completely separate. Now, many models which we actually use in practical, they are a hybrid or one or two approaches, or maybe more than two approaches. Now, you should think of families of different general approaches to generative model rather than explicit model architecture. So that's it guys for this short video of generative models and types of generative models. If you have watched this video till now, please like this video, comment on this video about the valuable feedback that you want to give it to me, and subscribe to the channel Data Fuse Analytics. Thank you guys and take care.